Hey guys, how you doing? Welcome back. 62 C10 project video today. We're gonna finish this real quick. It's not as rusty as the other side was. And then I'm gonna try to work on that rear spoiler area. I'm hoping to get them both done today. I'm gonna do these A-pillars separately. I'm gonna try to cut it at the 90 and salvage this and go from here over. It's not spot welded to the new headliner yet, so it should work fine. See, it's not really attached. So I cut this 90, form a new piece. It's got a slight radius to it. I don't know if you guys caught that in the other side. There is a slight radius to this. I mean, it's literally a degree or two over the whole span, so it's not much. So once I get this done back, then I can focus on these A-pillars, and the left and right A-pillars will be completely separate projects. I'll get one side done, then I'll do the other side. Like you can see down here where there's rust in these holes. So I got quite a bit of work. There's rust down here, down by the hinges, although it's pretty solid. It's rusty right next to solid spots. Then of course, this is a decoration part. It's gotta go from here down. Everywhere it's soft and rusty, I'm gonna have to replace. Today ought to be pretty easy, maybe a little bit boring. So I'm not gonna show you everything I do today. I'm gonna show you bits and pieces of this that I think might be a little interesting if I come across something I don't think I had in the video last week. And then when I do the spoiler, that'll be a little cooler because we're working with a little bit more of an area and trying to make the little step in the panel, so I'll be able to use the bead roller a little bit. I'd really appreciate it. I don't get as many views on these project truck videos as I do on my day in the shop videos. But if you're here because of the project and you haven't seen my day in the shop videos, check those out. Let's get into this thing. So I cut and grind and weld, and that's what we do. We're going to be past it soon, I promise, but you got to do it to get past it. That is beautiful. Tell you what, that Milwaukee drill, that thing is a beast. Literally a beast. Unlike these. These have been good for what I've been doing in these part sections though, but heavy duty Dremels, that's all they really are. And there's a little bit of a brace I gotta do in here, and I'll show you that when I get to it. Some of the bottom of the brace is rusted away. Ta-da! I cut a little too far in, so I'm gonna straighten this line out and just add material here. I finished cleaning this up. I'm trying to work with all the sparks. It's kind of hard to see. I don't know how guys like Fitzy and those guys cut on their mark lines with the sparks everywhere. It's really hard to see. Maybe I need a tinted shield for that. Let's start bending some metal. Well, I gotta cut out the pattern and then bend some metal. You don't have a painted show truck. You can lean on it, use it as a work bench. Same extra metal theory. I'm not gonna cut it to match this, because this is where that gap is, right? We're gonna cut that extra piece of strip out that was a little soft. I'm gonna clamp this to the sheet metal and use my air nimble. I'll get a nice straight line bumping it against that. Here it's gonna put it about there. Clamp on the other side, just so it's not in the way. This one sticks. Get that warranty. I think I paid like 20, 22 or 21 bucks a piece for these or something like that, I forget. I'm just eyeballing, not a critical measurement, but I gotta go by this shoulder rather than this one. It's quite a bit of difference. So I didn't realize this was so high, and this actually drops down about 3/8 of an inch, so. A noisy little bugger. I'm thinking about getting the metal shears. I don't know if you guys, any of you guys in the comments use those air metal shears. They work just like the hand ones, but air power. Easier on the arthritis, or just easier on your hands in general. You don't have to have arthritis to make your job a little easier. If I looked at a couple of them, and they vary in priced wildly. I'd probably buy the cheapest one that you guys think is decent if you have any experience with them. I wonder if Milwaukee might make one. As long as it's not $300 or $400, I might get one. Anyway, let me know in the comments. Got my first bend marked. I'm going to check again. What I will do is go in the generous side of the marker line. Let's take it over to the metal brake. It's not quite a 90. All right, double check, make sure my bends are on the right side. It's a little early in the process, so it really doesn't matter yet, I guess, but it's a good habit to be in. Now, this is pushing the edge at the limits of this metal brake, this 18 gauge. I'm not going to make this shorter. I'm going to do it in one piece, so the metal brake's going to have to deal with it. Whatever happens, happens. The closer I push it now, the less cutting and grinding I have to do. It would also help if my metal brake was bolted down, but it's not an option right now. I don't think that's going to be enough. Nope. It's pretty sturdy. I'm pushing on one handle because it's not bolted down, and it's still bending it pretty straight all the way across. I think I paid $300 for this metal brake. So far, so good. Let's get it out of there and see what it looks like. That's about perfect. Pretty lucky guess, huh? I don't want to brag, but one shot. We can see that there's a radius to it in both directions, of course. Every metal panel in almost every vehicle. It looks flat, it's not. Now this is that piece of the inner bracket I gotta duplicate before I weld this in. Once I get this all fabricated, I'm gonna work on making this little foot that goes in the brace inside that attaches all the panels. I am gonna replicate the seams a little bit. Not gonna be perfect, but we'll get it kind of looking like it did from the factory. I'm gonna shrink this edge just a little bit here. Try to pull the panel curved a slight bit. I mean, not much at all. To the eye, when I look at it, if I don't match the curve that was in there from the factory, even though it's slight, it'll have a curve and it'll be square and then it'll have a curve. I don't like it. I want it to have what it did from the factory, so. Yeah, this isn't touching in the middle by just a millimeter. This has to be shrunk a little bit. Yeah, both, this has to be shrunk a little and this has to be shrunk a little, so I get a slight curve here and I get a slight curve on the other side. Give you an idea how much of a radius there is in this panel. A couple degrees. So I want to match that because most likely the door, you know, whatever radius, this has a slight radius in it, the door has a slight radius too. Although the weather stripping will probably take it up. Why take the risk? Let's make it as close as it was before, right? So before I bend this little lip that I told you holds the weather stripping, I'm gonna have to do the stretching or shrinking, whatever it may be, before bending this little lip. Found that out on the other side the hard way. This side here has to be stripped so it goes away. Let's do one side at a time, see how that goes. I'm trying to figure out both sides at the same time. And it's too much for my tiny little brain. For some reason this always catches at the top. I don't see a stop adjustment screw. I might have to do something with this here so it stops it from over traveling and letting this come up and jam. Going pretty gentle. Like I did in the other one, I want to try to sneak up on it. And it's barely making a difference, I think, because this is so deep. I'm not getting the results I'm looking for. I need to get a little more aggressive. I'm going to mess with this a little more and we'll come back. I don't want to put music in the videos for a little while until I figure out what's going on, because it doesn't make any sense to make $6 on a video and pay $10 for the music. So let me cut this short, play with this a little bit, we'll come back. I gotta charge you guys anyway. You're down 40% already after 15, 20 minutes worth of footage. Take you over here to the charger where you belong. You guys could take a little break, you know? Probably getting a little tarred anyway. All right, you guys are charged up. I got a lot of work done here. I got this all welded in. What I ended up doing is tucking this bend up inside the original material that was there. Might have been a mistake on my part because I'm having a hard time getting the welds to grind smooth. I have to keep rewelding it and grinding it and rewelding. And this is about 4 passes. It's really solid metal now, but just doesn't look too pretty. I might try hitting it with 120 grit paper on a DA or something. Maybe that'll smooth it a little more gently than a grinder does. But anyway, now I'm making the bracket for the top. I'll show you guys what that looks like. Making this little bracket here. And I'm gonna make it longer to make up for what was rotted away and to go into the section I haven't repaired yet. Just because that way I'll have something to tack to once I do get in there. I might have to fix the bottom of that a little further up once this is cut out of my way. But we'll cross that bridge when we get to it. I'm gonna use my little spot weld chisel and push this down, just a little bit of tension on it. And everything will be nice and tight. Everything will be braced the way it's supposed to be. It would just bother me not to fix that, even though it's no one would ever see it. I did my welds on the inside and the out, like normal, make it nice and strong, so when I ground metal away, it would still be plenty strong. I'm gonna get this in here, and then we're gonna start on that back section. Hope that shows up on camera. I got you guys in the bed of the truck getting ready for what's to come. Show you guys what that looks like up close, because the camera's about 4 feet away and these little cameras do not like when I crop in more than a couple feet. So I'll bring you guys in for a ride. Woo! All right, now you can see what we're working with. Did two welds, simulated spot weld. That's how it was held together before. I don't want to drill another more holes in here and start doing it just to make it look like original. I just want the strength, so that's what we're doing. It was bent in, so I bent it in, and then I did my little two tacks. Full weld across there, because that panel holds a lot of stuff. I'm gonna probably put a couple of tack welds in the front too, but only where I can't get to it, because from below, I might have to cut this off and do a little bit more work in the front here. But let's hop in the back, see what we can get done. Let's get in the bed and see what we can do. I marked out what I think I want to cut. Everywhere it looks bubbly, got to come out. Especially if there's a hole and bubbles are not far from it. I got pretty solid metal. It's a little sketchy right here, but I really don't want to go into that curve if I can avoid it. Because it's like 3 weeks worth of work. You guys saw what happened with the headliner. Now, those of you who've been watching that long, I really appreciate that. Kind of leery of cutting off this outer lip. It's also got a step about a half inch in, a little less. It's got a step where the roof panel is going to sit on this little ledge, and then it drops in. It'll be interesting. I'm going to have to do it probably in two halves, because it's probably 28 inches long, 30 inches long, and my metal brake and my sheet metal pieces that I bought aren't big enough anyway. We got cutoff wheels, we got grinders. Well, I'll grind it after I cut it off. I'm not going to grind the metal I'm replacing and clean it up. Let's make our cut this way. It's always amazing to me how the cutoff wheels wear out faster on sheet metal than they do on metal brackets and stuff like that. Maybe it just seems that way, but something to do with the metal vibrating when you cut it, I believe. But that's what it looks like off the truck. Oh, I got a little curvature going on here, but that's it. I'm gonna draw these out on my sheet metal scrap. Let me clean up these edges real quick while we're up here. Might as well, right? All I can just, I'll be able to just get in there with my welder. I'll probably weld like I did on the side piece. I'll probably weld most of it from the top and do some touch-ups on the bottom so that I can grind and weld pretty easy upside down. Let's go make some panels. It's not pee-pee. It's, I put a few drops of that Great Value lemonade flavoring stuff for the water. After this one, I just cut that one edge off to do that over door area. After this one, I got one more. So I'm probably gonna need some more metal, but I'm not gonna order it till I'm sure. We'll see what happens. I got scrap from other projects and stuff too I can use in a pinch rather than waste material. This should be pretty simple piece, I'm thinking. Should I have said that? I find if I put the Sharpie line here and cut on the Sharpie line, it works out pretty good. I am gonna leave a little more this way just because there's a, I gotta put a bump in there. I might use the bead roller for that. I'm just gonna go about 4 or 5 millimeters up. That should be good. This one I'll cut afterwards, probably from the other side or something, I don't know yet. We'll see what happens. Try to stay on this line. What I'll do is try to sneak up here and finish off that sharp corner afterwards. Look out! Set it down, gentle. That's what you gotta do. Gonna have a little trim work to do here, but I expected that. That's interesting. I wasn't sure if it would do that. Just nibbles a little off the side. Doesn't like it, but it does it. We'll grind that the rest of the way. Very slight step. I don't know if you can see that on camera. It's maybe a millimeter, 12 thousandths, 15 thousandths, I don't know, something like that. Maybe 20. Anyway, I drew the I drew a first line where that step is, and then the second line is where the bend is. The more important thing to me is the flange. Now, what I got to figure out, I might be able to make this bend first and roll this through the flanger later. I got to change these dies, see if I could put that little bit of a flange in this. So once I loosen this bolt in the back, I can get these rollers off for the quarter inch bead. I use these to do that. I didn't film it, you guys were charging, but where I was talking about those pieces over the door where the gasket, the weather stripping hangs on that little rolled edge, I used this just to roll that edge and get it started. It doesn't roll it correctly, but it made a nice rolled edge for me to hammer over on the edge of the table. But all I did is just roll it through and just get that little rolled edge. I don't think I'm going to be able to put the bend in this first because the die is wider than that. If this was outside that width, I'd be able to put that 90 in it first. I think that's how we're doing it. These bolts, I'm not sure why they want you putting these bolts on here. Honestly, it doesn't really do anything. The die doesn't even touch this one. I do want these pretty close, but not pinched down. The closer these dies are, the sharper that bend is. The further they are away, the gentler the bend is. And this thing's pretty dang gentle. I'm not gonna get, you can see it there. I try to start off about the thickness of the metal. You gotta lock this down after you get close to where you want to be. I should be able to roll my flange. The flange is going to go here and the 90 afterwards, which should be good because I'll be able to bend it and won't affect it. Now, if you have this gap too tight, then you have a really hard time getting the metal started. This is best with an assistant so that they can roll the handle and you just guide the straight line. But smaller pieces, not too big of a deal. I think I've mentioned that before, but just in case. Big panels, you'd have to have someone helping you because you're trying to balance that piece of metal and all that kind of stuff, you know. Well, one pass I think about did it. That's why I bought the bead roller. Eastwood had it on sale. I think it's normally about $250. They had it on sale one day. Anyway, I ended up paying $165 for it. If you're gonna bend a lot of metal and you gotta do things like this, you don't wanna try to hammer and dolly that. I mean, you can see how nice that line comes out. That would have taken me an hour to hammer and dolly it and it wouldn't have looked as good. So that's why I bought it. I didn't wanna spend the money on it, but I mean, it's probably something, you know, Snap-on might resell it with their brand on it for $1,100 or something. I don't know. Just a joke. All right, same process on the second piece. I got the other one fitted pretty good. I'll show you guys in a second how it came out. Every time the arm goes to the backside, I can't really look where the metal's going. Wish I had longer arms, but I don't. Here's what it is. Take what you get. I could not win a slam dunk competition like that guy Mac did. That was pretty awesome. And if you guys know, we'll head over to the truck and show you how they're looking. Now, it is gonna have to have a slight curve too, I just realized too. It's not very much though, but you can see here if I line everything up. The panel fits nice though. The panel will fit nice. Once I get a little bit of a radius in it, this is where if you have an English wheel, you run this through the English wheel and just put a gentle curve in it. We don't have an English wheel, you know what we have? A sandbag and a really cool hammer. Man, it's not gonna take much at all. Just about 3 or 4 degrees. Careful. Don't trip when you're at the shop all by yourself. You slip and break your leg or something, you're on your own. I actually bring my cell phone out here with me, and I keep my cell phone in my tool cart. So if I did do something like that, I could get to my cell phone, hopefully. I'm here by myself, there's nobody within a half a mile. That's all right, I'm all good. The problem's gonna be trying to put that bend without messing up my seam. I'm gonna have to go real careful. Trusty Cook hammer, by the way. Made in the USA. Now it's gonna stretch the metal out a little bit. We'll have to fix that afterwards. I'm sure Fitzy or one of those guys would know a better way to do this, but I don't know a better way to do this. Try not to put this down in the grease and stuff. Now that's all part of the process. Tweak, straighten, bend, straighten, bend, straighten. All I want to do is get a little more curve in that. And I'll just keep going back and forth here. Try to make this fit and we'll come back. I found too that the bag is pretty good, but the table is really good because I got to curve away. So man, this little pocket too gets hot, man. Ugh. I really got to make something to put this on, some kind of work table that I can roll out of, in and out of here. It's a pain to hold this down and bend. There you go. That's about 90. Close to it. That's what we want. That was the specification from General Motors in 1962. They're like, how much we bend these? I said, close to 90. That's probably not true. Let's go over there and see how this stuff all fits. Well, we got two pieces of metal. I've been shrinking and stretching them a little too, but to match this. There's a slight arch this way, as well as a radius this way. So my two pieces have a slight arch to them. The height of this is a little high. I'm not worried about that. I'm gonna put it all together and wait. Even after I put the roof on, then I'll grind that edge so it matches pretty good and looks correct. I think we're about ready to weld these on. Now my first temptation is to get a little cocky, turn the welder on everything before I come up here, but you know, eventually you learn. that you're better off just going back to do it if you're in good shape and ready to go. I hate buying that gas, man. Especially when I feel like I didn't get use out of it and it disappeared. There are my two pieces. Got a little issue with the gappage on here. I think we are pretty close. You know what I should have done too? I mean, I've got these made pretty precisely to the ones I cut off, but I really should have measured from this lip to this lip, because now when I put the roof pan on, if it's, you know, I'm gonna have to tweak, basically is what I'm saying. I mean, the roof pan is gonna go on because this all moves, you know, so it's not that big a deal, but learning something today. I should have taken a measurement just to be sure, because I don't wanna have to tweak it when I put the roof on. I don't know if it shows up on camera. There's a little bit of the black Sharpie on there, and this piece of metal is just a little bit out. I gotta cut till I take all the Sharpie off. Oh man, I forgot too. I'm upgrading. I'm gonna go from my Amazon kit up to the Martin. Infamous B-Ran sent me. If you saw the tool video on Saturday, I'm gonna start using this thing since he sent it to me. Handle is a lot prettier. Shaped a little better. See how ergonomically shaped it is. This is just a straighter. I mean, this does the job. This is just nicer. And it's made in the US of A, which I prefer. Some people might not think so. I had a couple people unsubscribe after my last tool video. They left me a comment about how I supported China, but they didn't realize they were doing it on a Chinese-made device. But anyway, back to work. Rather than get this warrantied, I think this is pinched a little tight. Kind of fixed. It'll work. All right, the replacement metal is a little thicker than the original metal. The clamps won't squeeze it and stuff, but I'm going to use them just to kind of help me guide it. Well, isn't that interesting? Come here, welder. I need you to come with me. I don't want to get too close to this edge, but I can get within about a half an inch or so. Now, the way I measured everything out here, I knew I was going to end up with a little bit of a gap. I do have to grind a touch more off here. I needed to get this edge locked in before I can lock this at this corner in. Yeah, I got to take a little off this here. Little Milwaukee sounds angry with a fully charged battery. It's going, let me have it. I will grind it away. Corners are a little heat focuses in corners, so. Kind of don't want too many sharp corners anyway, but I'm trying to get out of the habit of cutting corners. No pun intended. Come on, I can't keep welding on the one piece. I gotta weld both. There you go. All right, guys, I'm gonna keep tack welding these in, working my way over. I'm gonna have to slice some more off here too, see how this gets long. That's one of the things that's hard to get really used to, but as you're welding, things shrink and stretch and everything basically shrinks. But when you weld two pieces of metal together, it pulls them in like this. I also had to get my gap just right as well because I'm cutting and fitting everything. If I do a cutting butt, I wouldn't have to do that, but I'm doing kind of a combination of both. I'm gonna take my cutoff wheel, clean this up a little bit. You know what I can do? I can do the cutting butt. I'll just tack it and then cut it. Let's see how this goes. I need my face shield, but I didn't bring it up here. So I'm doing it with my welding helmet protecting my eyes. And I have glasses on that are polycarbonate lenses. That's better. Give me that. Yeah, that's a good way to mess up the hardened surface on your spot weld chisel. I just got to stay away from it. This will work as a dolly, FYI. When you have a little bit of a gap to fill, you just want to hit the wire at an angle instead of straight, because so the wire doesn't just go through the hole. That's a waste of wire. I don't know where they got these cutoff wheels from. Paul gave me a couple cutoff wheels. They don't cut. I don't want to sound ungrateful. They're also a little thick. I'm getting a little too much of a gap. Bondo. Bondo is flammable. All right, let's cut off wheels. Something wrong. Let's go to this. Wasted a lot of time trying to get that cutoff wheel to cut. Now, we're getting somewhere. You guys get the idea, don't you? Now, before I get too committed, I gotta make sure nothing moved too much. This is just a tiny bit high. I'm gonna finish welding this up a little bit and show you what we got. I got it all welded up. I welded a little over here, and then I went over here, you know, back and forth all the way across. It's actually cooled off now. Came out really good, honestly. I thought it was gonna be harder. This whole piece took me the same amount of time as the piece over the door, which I thought the piece over the door would be really quick. Shows you how much I know about metalwork. I still gotta grind this to make it the same height all the way across and all that, but I might even, like I said earlier, put the roof panel on and then grind everything to make sure it sits the way I want. Because you don't know until you tweak everything and get it all flat. See, this all moves. So it's welded in really good though. I got a lot of grinding to do. I'm gonna probably bring in the Dunkin' Donuts coffee in the morning real early and try to grind that all before work and stuff like that. So I'll add to the footage the grinding and a little bit of it and what the finished product looks like when we're all done. So you guys want to check out the finished product? I got it ground down a little bit. So I'll ground all my welds down. I don't really even have to grind these. For appearance, you're not going to see it. But if you watch my other videos, you don't want moisture and condensation to gather on top of the welds and keep it from trailing down. It's designed to trail down. So even though it's gonna have a roof on it, moisture and condensation still gather and dry over and over again. That's what caused the rust in the first place. So welds would trap it and make it rust again. I'm probably gonna put a little skim of Bondo on here rather than hammer and dolly and continue welding and trying to make it all perfect with no Bondo. Probably easier just to skim it with Bondo real quick. There's a couple little holes I'm definitely gonna fill in all the little holes I can see light through and grind it again one more time. But basically done. I'm gonna throw some primer on it and I'll show you what that looks like. I went ahead and put some primer on this passenger door jamb so you can see what that looks like there. Not perfect, but I'm happy with it. That is gonna work for me. So I might skim a little Bondo over some of the little weld holes or something like that. I'm not sure yet. We'll see. All right, I threw a little primer on there now. So you see how it looks, came out pretty good. Couple little pinholes here. I'm gonna have to touch those up. It'll be perfect. Well, thanks for watching this video, guys. I hope you got something from it. If you're working on your project, looking for a little motivation. It doesn't have to be a 62 C10 Chevy short bed. It can be anything. This truck's pretty rare and pretty rusty. But because it's a big window short bed truck, I wanted to try to resurrect it rather than scrapping it and getting a different cab and all that kind of stuff. But plus I like a challenge. You guys who watch my videos probably know that. I like a challenge a little too much. I'm getting a little older. I'm gonna have to cut back on the challenges, but You guys don't have to cut back on subscribing or torquing the like button or any of that if you want. There's no charge for that. It really helps the channel out, so I'd appreciate it if you did that. Maybe share the video with, you know, someone who's working on their project vehicle looking for a little motivation. I got this whole series on my main page on YouTube. All my project truck videos are there, as well as my day in the shop and tool reviews, all kinds of stuff. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope I see you in the next video, because you're awesome.